RiseMag.com.
We're here today at AUSA 2016. Who inspired you to be a voice actor?
Honestly, it's something that I kind of fell into. I was already a stage actor from a very young age and had done some film work as well, and worked for a theater company, still work for this theater company in Austin, Texas, called the Rude Mechs, the Rude Mechanicals, and we make original, experimental, devised work. They've been around for about 20 years. I've been with them since about 1991, and a gentleman that we would collaborate with from time to time, I guess around 2006 maybe, that date may be wrong, in any case. He happened to be a director for ADV through, they had a studio in Austin at the time where I live, called Monster Island Studios. Lowell Bartholomew is his name. And he was directing a show called The Get Backers. And at that time, you would hire an actor for a 6-episode arc and then, you know, re-up their contract if everything worked out, and they'd do the whole series if, ultimately, if everything was cool. But apparently he wasn't into, after the first 6 episodes, one of his leads, the gentleman who was playing Bon Lidau. And he and I met at a birthday party at a bar. We'd met before in the theater realm, but we'd never really hung out or talked, and we kind of shut the bar down that night talking, and at the end of it, he said to me, you know, you've got a pretty good voice, and I'm not having that great of an experience with my actor in this particular role. Would you mind coming into the studio Monday and seeing if you have a knack for this? And ultimately, it seems I had a knack for it, because the rest is history. Just kind of built from there. But super, super cool, fun work. Way lower stress. Typically, occasionally you've got a stressful moment. Weird flaps or whatnot. But yeah, it's pretty chill to be in a booth, and you know, especially if you really dig the character.
Were you a fan of anime or gaming before you got into the business?
I was. I am, you know, not super young. I was into, when I was a kid, and still am into Akira, the movie, and the graphic novels as well, Robotech, and Star Blazers. So these are pretty old school titles, I know, but that's when I was a kid, and also played D&D. Yeah, so yes, video games were not part of my repertoire at that age, though. My father was pretty strict about technology. I got to watch one 30-minute program on Saturday mornings, and the rest of it was what he chose. So I did get to see some cool stuff. Like, we stayed up to watch Saturday Night Live, for instance, during a pretty cool era. But yeah, most of the other stuff, reruns of the Rockford Files, were not my cup of thing, as my father would say. Anyway.
Is there any fandoms that you are currently into?
I don't know if I know what you mean.
Like, if you're like a large part of like Star Wars, for instance, like, do you like follow any of the, like, the fandom information? Like, get into like reading fan fictions, or like looking at fan art, or like just being a part of the fandom in general?
I don't know that I feel so much a part of it, but I definitely feel peripherally involved given the nature of my work. I mean, I end up seeing a lot of fan art through social media and also my convention circuit. So I guess I'm not technically involved, but I feel like I'm slightly involved, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And I especially like seeing renderings and interpretations of characters that I've voiced, that I'm, especially the ones that are my favorites, like Yato.
Do you have any dream roles?
Absolutely. I don't know that I'll ever achieve them. Roy Batty from Blade Runner, probably never going to play him. Rick Deckard from Blade Runner, probably never going to play him. Batman, one of my compatriots has already taken that. In any case, yes. Yes, I do. But most of them have already been done. Deadpool, Ryan Reynolds did a pretty good job, I guess. Anyway.
Do you have any techniques for getting into character?
You know, I've been doing it so long that I think that my technique, my method, is kind of built into the point that I'm not particularly specifically aware of it. I tend to get into character and stay in character throughout the duration of something. Not like I won't, you know, I'm not going to do what Jared Leto did in that Suicide Squad, where he never left it for months and scared the crap out of people. It's not like that, but, you know, if I've got to do an accent, like for Empire of Corpses, for instance, I tried to stay in that accent for most of the recording sessions because it was pretty specific. And it also wasn't one that I hadn't. I guess when I've done English accents, they've usually been more street. He's more refined, and we had a dialect coach on that. I typically don't have a dialect coach, but because I needed to sound like a posh Londoner, we employed one in that particular instance. And also because I wanted to maintain the authentic nature of that particular accent. Yeah, I stayed in that instance, but not always. I guess it depends on how foreign it is to me. And there are still some that I'm good at them, but there's some that I can't get a handle on. And weird ones, like, I don't know. I'm not very good at Minnesota, like Fargo. I don't know. It eludes me. But English, Irish, Australian, all that stuff, yeah, I can work with those.
Do you play Pokemon Go by any chance?
I don't, but I have a 7.5-year-old who does, so I feel like I do, because I wander around with him with my phone while he finds Pokemon. Which is, it's interesting, because he keeps telling me that he doesn't really like Pokemon, but he likes Pokemon Go. And I really have to watch him when he's wandering around with my phone, not just because he has my phone, but because he'll just, like, I'm like, Sid, you're straight up going to wander right into traffic. Like, anyway, no, I don't play myself, though.
Do you tend to be more animated within the booth or more stationary?
Both. For fight reacts, I have inadvertently struck the microphone or the pop screen. I find that sometimes it's difficult to get that sound out of you if you don't do anything. Largely, it is a compartmentalized art, I feel like. You know, it's like a little segment, a little facet of acting. But you still have to get all of everything out of it with using just your voice, right? So when something is very, very physical and you've got your character jumps straight up into the sky and comes slamming down with this massive battle yell. Sometimes I've hit some stuff.
Has working in this business fulfilled any of your bucket list goals?
Yes, in that it's made it possible for me to live and work exclusively as a performer and an actor. Before I started doing this, I always had to have side jobs, and this is kind of picked up the slack in that regard. So, absolutely.
Out of all the characters that you have played, who is the most like you, and then who is the least like you?
That's interesting. I don't have a ready answer for that. Huh. I would say, I know that in a lot of instances, the context is kind of fantastical, you know? It's not necessarily totally realistic, even in the more kind of filmic anime. But Akira Takizawa is probably somewhat close to my persona when I'm in a good mood. I feel like that about Yato sometimes too, though. I mean, I get kind of crazy and schizophrenic and weird and goofy. You know, I get a little too tired, and you get that second wind and the goof sets in. But again, you know, it's not fully there. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Was there another part to that question?
Which would be the least like you?
Huh. trying to think. Maybe Finian from Black Butler. If there were people here, they'd be like, aww. He's just, I'm not really that gentle and sweet, I guess. I mean, I am sweet, but not in that he very much is a deferential, he has a deferential personality, if that makes sense. I don't know, I tend to kind of go for it.
Has acting changed the way you view the entertainment industry?
I would say yes. Probably not in positive ways necessarily. It's a cutthroat realm. It's a hard way to make a living. And I've had friends who have achieved success change. And, you know, we're still friends, but they are distinctly different. And I've had people tell me that they feel like I'm different. In certain instances, which I don't see, but I think that there is an effect, and it's not always positive.
Do you watch any of the shows or play any of the games that you're currently in or been in?
I watched Noragami. I watched Eden of the East. I watched Darker Than Black. I play Borderlands too. There's probably others that I've watched, but those are the main ones.
Mm-hmm. What is the best part about being a voice actor?
I think it's being able to, I don't know, when I was a kid, I the first thing I wanted to be was a brain surgeon, and then that changed a few times. And I feel like when you're an actor, you can kind of be all of the things. And you're not stuck in it. You get to change it up every once in a while, or often, and especially now that Funimation has teamed up with Crunchyroll and we're doing these broadcast dubs. I did a 2-day stint last week where I think I voiced 5 characters in 2 days, 7 hours a day, which is pretty crazy. It's like the animation factory. And that probably contributes to my innate schizophrenia anyway, not in the, you know, clinical sense. It is very, very interesting and entertaining, and I feel like I've had a taste of certain things. Not as much, honestly, not as much in the voice work. Well, I guess it depends on the project. I know I'm waffling like crazy. Like Empire of Corpses, for instance, I don't know if you've seen it, but it playing Dr. John Watson, this I don't know, And doing it for that kind of feature-length film, so it was many, many cues, so many, many hours of work. You start to feel like, especially with the other voice as well, you start to feel like you're embodying this a little bit, and you look at things a little bit differently, like more like a scientist or a doctor would. And I know it's not, you know, it doesn't directly apply, it's probably not exactly the same thing, but ultimately, the way your perspective is what matters, what counts in that regard, right?
Mm-hmm.
Out
of all the characters that you've played, which one would make your best road trip companion?
That is a good question. For a lot of them, I'd actually be a little afraid of what might happen ultimately. Like, you know, it could start with Yato, but who knows where he'd go. Mordecai drinks too much. Maybe, this is a weird one. Maybe the kid that I played in Wolf Children. So hey, super mild and cute, and I could pick the places that we ate. He probably wouldn't help with gas, but that's cool. He's a kid. That's a weird answer, I know, but it's kind of a weird question. Anyway, no offense.
If you can montage your career into one song, what would it be?
Oh, wow. These are crazy questions. Maybe Faith No More Epic. And I don't want to explain that.
And finally, do you have any advice for your fans?
Be good to yourselves and enjoy life as much as possible. Take advantage of every opportunity that appeals to you within reason.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
WeRiseMag.com.